check out this oldie. This is a 1994 Jayco Eagle 290. This has a really unique floor plan. It was owned by an older couple in their 70s, might even be in their 80s. Garage kept the whole time, so it's in beautiful condition for the Northeast. And I just want to quickly show you through this floor plan, because it's not often I'll get a 1994 that looks like this that comes through here. So let's check this out. Let me know what you think.
Okay, let's walk around the outside, starting right around the front corner here. We'll see it was built on this beautiful Ford E350 chassis. We can still see all the metal on that front bumper. That's a real built bumper. All the paint, no rust. Tires are in good condition. Seals are in good condition. This is the Jayco Eagle 290. I believe it's the J. It comes with an Onan 4000 generator. Pass-through storage here. Then into our water connections with our city water connection and our fresh water fill. All these have window awnings. And there's your hood fan. We just replaced the water heater in there. Then over here is our 30 amp power cord. Down below, more storage. Some nice looking Cooper tires on here, 225/75 R16s. They are a dually. This is a gasoline tank. Right here showing our dump station. Gray is okay, black is for crap. Gray is the drains, black is the toilet. And then a huge pass-through storage back here. It's slim, but it's wide. Showing the back bumper. Those caps pull off and we can store things inside. Full-size spare tire. Oh, and let's try to climb up on the roof with one hand. Don't recommend doing this. But we'll see up top, there's a roof rack right here. All the vents were replaced. Went through and sealed the roof. And I assure you, the ladder held. On the other side, we have the other pass-through storage. Nice large manual awning. ...110 power. Oh, the Jayco Eagle series. And the 290 was their biggest series for this year. They had two different floor plans in the 290. The other one had a twin bed. Right there was a furnace exhaust, and here's the fridge access panel. There's a three-way fridge inside of here. I believe it's a Norcold. We ended up putting some brand new steps on there. The other side of the pass-through storage here up front. Here's a propane. And for a 94, this looks great. There's that manual awning. Can't remember what size it was, but I know it's a long one. Probably 10 to 12 by my estimate. And now, let's go inside and check out the interior. As we walk in, we'll see all this beautiful carpet. I do love all that wood. It's got that wood interior and the wallpaper. Captain's chairs, and this is the best part right here, is you never see the jackknife sofa in the middle of the living space. Just a very unique floor plan. This thing only has 97,000 miles on it. Runs and drives phenomenal. And the funniest part is it almost looks like the interior of my 2040 Countline that I personally own. Here's the cab over bed. Looks nice, well maintained, no leaks. They even sent a TV with us. Into the table. That table has an extra leaflet that pulls out and gives you more table room. There's a jackknife sofa, so that folds into a bed. Cabinets up top. Some artwork on the wall. Right there's our air conditioner. The other table and captain's chair with a magazine rack. Now up top into our entertainment area where they keep the DVD player or VCR at the time. Another cabinet. Some home decor from the previous owners. Into our kitchen area. They definitely don't lack in countertop space and cupboards and drawers. Underneath the sink. Down in there was a water heater. Double sink with the cutting board. Three burner stove with the oven. They even put storage below the oven. Again, not something you see too often. Cock-a-doodle-doo. Right there is a microwave, just a standard microwave, overhead cabinet. Into our three-way fridge. Operations for the three-way fridge and how to switch it back and forth. Freezer section up top. Fridge section down below. With a drawer underneath that. That drawer is full of stuff. And that's just an intake. Air intake. Now we're going into the bathroom. I know it's a little messy, guys. This isn't technically our camper yet, but we know we're bringing it in, so I didn't want to clean it yet. All the overhead cabinets and the blinds, fan over top. Then we'll go into the back bedroom with a walk-around queen-size bed. We do have a spot for a TV in here and speakers overhead. His and her wardrobe. Closets on both sides with little hangers. Overhead cabinets above the bed with our overhead lights that you can reach when you're sitting up. Drawers underneath the wardrobes. No, just to show you the other side. It looks exactly like the one side, but it's nice to visualize it and see it. Queen size bed. And then as we go out of the bedroom, directly across from the toilet is the shower. They are two different doors, so we can do two different things as in two different people. Now just walking through and just showing you the overall floor plan.
All right, welcome to the end of the video. Thanks for sticking around and watching the whole thing. I hope you love this awesome gem that we found. 1994 Jayco Eagle 290. This is a sweet camper. Obviously, you're seeing the reason why. This center sofa is phenomenal. I've never seen anything like it. And I've lived in an 89 Gulfstream Conquest at one point in my life. So it's not like I'm new to the old school stuff. They just don't build them like this anymore. To see the floor, to see the, you know, that nostalgic color scheme and the quality and condition of it. It's just awesome. I currently live in a converted camper van, so keep on coming back. If you do like watching these, hit that subscribe button. I'm always here. Thanks for coming. Thanks for watching.
Until next time.